Victory is a question of stamina. This poster dates from 1917 and was published by the U.S. Food Administration. The artist is Harvey Dunn. The poster was in poor condition, and we gave it a poster fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Posterfix Studio. Harvey Dunn was an American illustrator who studied with Howard Pyle, the father of American illustration. Harvey Dunn was also the instructor of my art instructor, both in high school and beyond, Charles J. Andres. And I am privileged today to be able to show you a poster by Harvey Dunn, who I believe to be one of the best of the illustrators of that era. The first thing I have to do is prepare a screen. That means I have to take a big stretcher screen that I have constructed out of 2x4s and remove the old staples from the previous linen backing job.
Posters get rips on the edges. Let's get scotch tape on the back. I have to take off.
It is important that we remove all the foreign objects from the back of the poster. For example, old tape and old glue residues. We want to use a water-based wheat paste to mount this to the acid-free paper. But before we do that, we have to make sure the back of it is very clean of old glues or anything. The following biographical data on Harvey Dunn comes from the JVJ Publishing website. Harvey Thomas Dunn was born in 1884 on the Dakota prairies, where he lived on his parents' homestead until he was 17. He was a large boy who was capable of doing a man's job by the age of 14. It's a wonder that he had had time for schooling, farm work, and drawing. He did all three remarkably well, and in 1901 he left the farm to enroll at South Dakota Agricultural College. It was there he met a young teacher named Ada B. Caldwell, who quickly recognized his talent and recommended that he continue his studies at the Chicago Art Institute. In 1902, in his only suit and toting his belongings in a trunk, the lanky farm boy set off for the dizzying sophistication of Chicago. He earned his tuition doing odd jobs and janitor work and as a farmhand during the summer. He drew and he painted, and he convinced a school of disbelievers that the hick from the prairie was an artist. At the age of 20, he convinced Howard Pyle of his talent and was accepted into the master's class at Wilmington and Chad's Ford.
There's still a piece of scotch tape on here. These rips will come together once it's limited back, mostly clean rips.
By 1906, Harvey Dunn was on his own, making a living in the burgeoning and competitive world of commercial illustration and selling his art to the insatiable magazine markets of the day. After Pyle died in 1911, Dunn left Wilmington for Leonia, New Jersey to be closer to his New York markets. The Saturday Evening Post was one of his best clients. Inspired by Howard Pyle's example, Dunn opened the Leonia School of Illustration in 1915 with Charles Chapman. Dean Cornwell, who attended the classes for the few years the school existed, said, "I gratefully look back on the time when I was privileged to sit at Harvey Dunn's feet. He taught art and illustration as one. He taught it as a religion, or awfully close to such." Dunn was 33 in 1917 and past the age of military service, but he was chosen as one of a cadre of eight artists who were commissioned to serve as graphic reporters of combat activities on the front. This poster is an example of that kind of work. He was a fearless reporter and filled scrolls with powerful images that he drew in the trenches. Images of devastation, both physical and emotional. He wanted desperately to transform these reams of drawings into finished paintings and expected to be kept on the national payroll as he completed the proposed canvases. But he was discharged in 1919, immediately after the war, and he had to return to commercial work to support himself and his family.
We're spraying water on the poster to help it expand. The poster will stretch out as it absorbs the wheat paste and the water. Now we're rolling out the excess wheat paste in air pockets to make sure the poster is good and flat. This is something we've done after it expands.
His drawings still exist, many at the Smithsonian, and display an emotional power that still can overwhelm the viewer, even today. Settling back into the illustrative grind was simply not as satisfying as it had been before his war experiences. He moved to Tenafly, New Jersey in 1919 and built a large studio adjacent to his new home. This poster is from 1917. And it is meant to encourage people to save the fatty, rich foods for the soldiers on the front lines. Although this poster was published by the U.S. Food Administration, it resembles a military recruitment poster, basically telling you why the soldiers need energy.
Now that we've got Harvey Dunn linen backed, we're going to let it dry for a few days and then we're going to commence with the restoration. It's sharing a screen with all these other World War I posters. Chateau Tierney, Lyme, June 13th, 1918. This is a hand-drawn map from World War I. Drawn in crayon, which shows the plans of the American military. Line before the Somme retreat of 1917, line after the Somme retreat until March 20th, 2018. This map is getting linen backed to preserve it. We'll get rid of these wrinkles. Well, we've got this flattened out now on the linen backing and it's drying. Now we're gonna do this one, Vive la France, all for one and one for all. This poster is by Flag, very interesting. All right, now I've flattened this on the screen and it's expanding. And once it's expanded, I'll roll it out. Now she is all linen backed and flat and she will dry for a while. Meanwhile, on this side of the screen, we've got a few half sheet posters going down. And now this one is flat. And now we must do this one for Bagged in France. Thank you.
Hello, this is Chris. How may I help you? Yes. Yes, we restore vintage posters. Oh, absolutely. We do a lot of World War I posters. We probably do thousands of them a year. There's not a World War I poster I haven't seen. Well, what I suggest you do is take some pictures of it so that I can see the condition. And send me a few shots of it front and back. And also tell me the size and anything else you want to tell me about it. And when you ship it to me, be sure it's not in the frame. It's much safer for the poster to have it taken out of the frame. And also that way you can really see its condition better when it's out of the frame. A poster in a frame is almost impossible to tell what's going on with it. All right? Okay. My email address is chris@posterfix.com. I look forward to seeing your poster. Thanks. More and more, he felt the need to create lasting art in addition to illustration. He was commissioned to paint 5 mural-like panels for the 100th anniversary of a New York department store in 1925, but this failed to supply him with the fulfillment he sought. In 1928, a venue opened up for Dunn to complete several of his proposed war canvases. The American Legion Monthly magazine began to feature his paintings as covers, and Dunn's vision of the war was recorded for posterity. There were still 2 other goals yet to be reached, teaching and capturing the beauty of his native Dakotan prairie. There were still 2 other goals yet to be reached, teaching and capturing the beauty of his native Dakotan prairie. The Legion magazine covers allowed him a venue for the latter, and teaching was never far from his thoughts. Howard Pyle's legacy would never find a more ardent supporter nor capable disciple. Dunn taught. It was part of his life. He taught at the Grand Central School of Art, at the Art Students League in New York, and in his studio for selective advanced students. His classes were popular and productive. Pyle would have been proud. His students included Cornwell, Harold von Schmidt, Saul Tepper, John Clymer, Lehman Anderson, James Allen, Mario Cooper, and Charles J. Andres. Charles J. Andres was my art instructor in high school at Berwick Academy in South Berwick, Maine, and continued to be an influence and friend to me for the remainder of his life. Charles J. Andres passed away in 2008, just a few months after my son Zachary was born. In 1934, Harvey Dunn was captured in print in An Evening in the Classroom, being notes taken by Miss Taylor in one of the classes on painting conducted by Harvey Dunn and printed at the instigation of Mario Cooper. This is what Harvey Dunn said about teaching illustration and art. Quote, "All that I am really doing is carrying on the Howard Pyle idea. Howard Pyle did not teach art. Art cannot be taught any more than life can be taught. His main purpose was to quicken our souls that we might render service to the majesty of simple things." Unquote. And there you have it. Another poster restored at Posterfix. This one by the master painter and illustrator, Harvey Thomas Dunn. This is Chris. After 33 years of restoring vintage posters, I still look forward to seeing what you're going to send me. I appreciate your time and look forward to seeing your vintage posters. Thank you.